Thank you. all and thank you all for being here today. You were all invited because you are someone important and special in the individual and collective lives of John and Terry. And speaking of these two, we all would like to thank you for taking time away from your music festivals, your birthday parties, first communion, congrats, Brandon, and even a trip to New York. And you guys, this was all in the month of May, before they got married. Oh, and after, you know, a short little stint in Hawaii. But as was said by the deeply profound philosopher, okay, author, Dr. Seuss, you know you are in love when you don't want to fall asleep because reality is finally better than your dreams. Will that, or you've an insanely insane social schedule, and you literally have no time to sleep. But that is just one of the many reasons why these two are perfect for each other. Their love of music, their sense of adventure, that live life to the fullest mentality, and just their overall pure stamina, in all sense of that word. But on a more serious note, I'd like to read a quote by the Dalai Lama that really resonated with John and Terry. We don't know whether the universe, with its countless galaxies, stars, planets, has a deeper meaning or not. But at the very least, it is clear that we humans who live on this earth face the task of making a happy life for ourselves. Therefore, it is important to discover what will bring the greatest degree of happiness. And I think John and Terry are doing just that. They've discovered what makes them happy, and more importantly, who makes them happy. As you know, John and Terry met just a little over 1 year ago, and they feel so fortunate to have found each other, you know, later in life. And when I say later in life, no, I'm not saying they are old. I mean, look at these two. I mean, John, I get it. You're a guy. You're supposed to, like, look better with age. Terry, this has to stop. I mean, can you please start aging at some point? This is ridiculous. Yeah.
Seriously.
No, but really, they don't feel like they were only lucky to found each other. You know, didn't just come from an intro from a friend. Or maybe John's stalker-like persistence. Terry meet up before the famous game night. But, you know, maybe called a divine intervention. But they really feel like there was a little help from the big guy upstairs. Speaking of people watching over us from above, I'd like to take a minute to recognize those who were taken way too early from us and could not physically be with us here today. But they will always be with us in spirit and always in our hearts. Terry's sister, Kathy, her nephew, Michael, and of course, Terry's daughter, Marissa, who is a part of her, who is always with her, and is absolutely a part of this special day. There are also some family members who are unable to travel, but are supporting you guys from afar. Terry's mom, Linda, her father, Pat, John's parents, Kat and Marilyn. And now we will have a reading by sweet, sweet Deanie.
Happy?
Let me see if I can read through the tears. Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. Good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you, at least once a day. And in your case, it's probably way more. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking each other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon, which we all know it won't. It should continue through the years. It is having mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together, facing the world. It is forming
a circle of love that gathers the whole family, which we all know. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor, which we know you both have. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other the atmosphere in which each can grow old. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. And you two are perfect for one another. We love you.
We love you too. That was beautiful, Amy. Now let's hear from these beautiful people. John and Terry have written their own vows that they'll be sharing with you.
Oh, God.
And I thought I'd have John go first because, you know, he's a man. Unless you're, you know, you feel like a woman. Another reason was we all know John's a crier.
Teresa Beckner.
Yes.
For a few more minutes anyway. When we first met last March, I fell for you. Your smile captivated me on the first night. Our conversations excited me. Then your heart allowed me in, and I fell in love with you shortly after. You and I are not perfect, but you're perfect for me. You make me smile. You make me a better man. We make this world a better place. My kids, my grandkids, and my parents never question my choice. They love you almost as deeply as I do. Brandon showed me love and acceptance immediately. He knows I love you, and he knows I'm going to take care of you. Marissa would be so proud of her mom to be where she's at today and the strength that got her here. I know she's up there smiling down on us, now and always. I never met her, but I know her. And I know you miss her. And our kids love us. That's a pretty big deal. My friends, your friends, now our friends, are some of the most amazing people in the world. Back to our friends. So, she's my other half. Okay, so our friends, some of the most amazing people. They've been there for us at our worst, believe me. And now they're here today with us at our best. And we love you all. So you and I have traveled some pretty bumpy roads in our individual lives. And it brought us here today. I'd say the journey was worth it. But those bumpy roads now will be part of our journey, and we'll actually seek them out. Our journey is just beginning. The universe is on our side. I want to explore every corner of the earth with you. But I also want to sit next to you on the side of a riverbank, just holding your hand. Get ready. Then dancing naked in the field to our favorite song. You are the best friend I've ever had. You have given me your whole mind, your body, and your soul. And I've gladly been able to give that back. I will always share my thoughts and feelings with you, knowing that they are safe. I have never felt so wholly connected to a woman, ever. Terry, no promises were made to us by this world, but I promise I will love you and keep you safe. I will never lie to you, steal from you, or cheat against you. But if I do lie, it will be beside you. If I steal, rest assured, it will be your heart.
Sorry.
And if I cheat, let it be death, so I'm here longer with you. And lastly, I'm forever yours, faithfully.
I have to admit, I was not too thrilled in meeting you at first. I remember on game night, Kimberly calling me and saying, hey, we're going to have game night and I'm going to invite someone and he wants your phone number. And I didn't want to give it to you. I said, no. I just want to meet him there, right? And you were so persistent. You were like, just persistent. I finally caved in to Kimberly and I said, okay, here's my phone number. Give it to him. And he texted me right away. Hey, this is John. You know, would you like to go out to dinner? And I said, no, I'm super busy. I said, no, I've got some things after work, during work. It was okay. Coffee. I said no. I can't right now. And then finally, he goes okay. A phone call. And I was like, okay, I'll give him a phone call. I'll just have Brandon come in. And, hey, mom, someone's at the door. So we set a time, and you never called me. I waited, and I said. I want to even give him my phone number. I just wanted to meet him game night and kind of just have it casual, but no. And I was like, okay. So I texted him. I said, you know, it's been an hour. I said, and I know I did miss a phone call from you. I said, see ya. And then he was apologetic on the text. And so game night came and we met, and pretty much everything was history from there. We ended up on the couch late at 3:00 in the morning, massaging each other's feet, talking about our lives, and I fell over. So, and if any of you guys know me very well, I love my feet massaged. I do the best. And he did a great job that night. So weeks turned into months. My feelings grew more and more stronger for you each day. I love the fact that we both have loved to do the same things, and have things in common, like camping and traveling and spending time with family and friends. and being alone together with whatever we're doing. I will never forget the time we went to Reno to meet Hermina and Dave and to see the house that you were having built. You were so excited, you remind me of a little boy. Describing, oh, this is the front door, because it was just a concrete slab of the door. And I was like, oh, this is the front door, this is gonna be my office, and here's the bedroom, and then of course here's the master bedroom. I'm thinking in my head, our bedroom, our kitchen. And the whole time I'm thinking, this man that I'm falling in love with is going to be leaving to Reno and moving, and how am I gonna be able to deal with this? And so he jumps off the slab and he's telling me about how he's gonna decorate the backyard. And he comes back up and he looks at me and he says, can I tell you something? I said, yes. And he puts his hands on my face and held it gently and said, I love you. And my heart leapt. Like, I was so excited because as Marte knows, my feelings are just so strong for this guy, it could really hurt. And at that moment I knew, oh, finally, I feel like he feels the same way about me. It was a moment I'll never forget. It was amazing. And little did I know that you had asked my dad and my son for my hand in marriage. That was the sweetest thing ever. And I thought to myself, what kind of man is this? This is amazing. And I got a good one, that's for sure. And my dad, he still talks about that day, you going into the facility and getting down on one knee in the cafeteria while he was recovering, and you asking for my hand in marriage. He just thought that's the most amazing thing. And I will never forget that. And neither will he. And then you asked Brandon, and that was just amazing. Your gentle, loving kindness ways to my dad is the most beautiful feeling a daughter could ask for. Holding my dad's hand and massaging his feet to get the circulation in his legs when he wasn't feeling well in the hospital, it was just, really, what kind of man does this? I know, I got one of the good ones. And I'm so blessed to have you in my life. This leads me to Brandon. He loves us together, and I remember telling Brandon, tell me if you see any red flags, okay? He said, none so far, Mom. I really like this guy. I said, me too, son. I hope things work out. It fills my heart with love that Brandon feels the same way that I feel about you. And Brittany, too. She loves us together as well. And the rest of my family approves. Morgan and Chris, that one was for you guys. You knew what I'm talking about. And your beautiful children, Janelle, Stephen, Carly, and Johnny, and your grandchildren, Dominic, Brayden, Brody, and especially your little sweet Gianna. Love you. I promise to love and cherish them always and be the best grandmother and mother-in-law that I can be. I'll be there when they need me. I'll hold their hands if they're sick. If they have questions, anything, I'm always there. What? Oh yeah, I'm a bonus mom. Not a mother-in-law, a bonus mom. Okay. I'm honored to be called Grandma Titi and or Babushka or Babushka too. I promise. Oh, pardon me. Also, as difficult as it is not having my Marissa physically here today, I know she's looking down on us with love and happiness, and she would love us together. I know it in my heart. The tree that you got to plant in our backyard to honor her was the most endearing thing. And the picture frame that you had done to me when we just started dating. I thought, what kind of man does this? I got one of the good ones. So the day came, and you asked me to marry you in one of the most beautiful places in the world, Yosemite Falls. On this day, I was the happiest I've been in years. I have the man of my dreams, and he's all mine. you bring me joy and happiness, and you have this way about you that comforts me and makes me feel safe. I can't wait to start our life together, to grow old together, cry and laugh together in good and bad times, and always side by side. I love you so much, honey. And from this moment on, I know our love will continue to grow year after year, so here we are, our wedding day. You make me so happy and love, honey. Cheers to us and to all of our life's adventures to come. I love you.
Those are very sweet, guys, and informative. Straight from the feet, huh, man? I, John, take you, Terry.
I, John, take you, Terry.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
I love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
Whatever may come, I will always be there.
Whatever will come.
Now, Terry. Please repeat after me. I, Terry, take you, John.
I, Terry, take you, John.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
My partner in life.
My partner in life.
And my one true love.
And my one true
love. I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever. Whatever may come, I will always be there. And as one said in one of the most romantic comedies of all time, When Harry Met Sally, when you realize you want to spend the rest of your life with somebody, you want the rest of your life to start as soon as possible. So let's get that life started, shall we? And I'm going to read a few things, and then if you willingly agree at the end, you'll say, I do. And again, I'll start with John. Will you, John, take Terry as your favorite person? Hold up, Bronco. Will you love her unconditionally and support her by pushing her cute little butt out the door when she's running late? Will you promise to buy her whatever her current drink of choice is at the time, whether that's a vodka press, a chilled shot of tequila, or a monstrosity of a cocktail that costs $24.
Yes, you.
And finally, will you always happily be by her side, even if it's at 3 a.m. when she's flipping through her phone because she can't sleep?
Yeah.
If you willingly agree, please say I do.
I do.
Now, Terry, do you take John as your favorite person? Will you love him unconditionally? And we tell him his feet are pretty on a regular basis. Will you continue to support and join John on his quest to out-party any 20-year-old at any music festival across the land? And finally, will you be a willing and smiling participant in the famous John Fee Jack selfie? If you willingly agree, please say I do.
I do.
All right, now let's put a ring on it. And would that be Brody?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. You guys ready? The ring is an ancient symbol of wholeness and peace. It has no beginning and it has no end. It is round like the sun, like the moon, like arms that embrace. It is a circle for that love that is given comes back. May these rings remind you of the love that was shared today, tomorrow, and always. John, as you place a ring on Terry's finger, please repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a pledge of my love.
As a pledge of my love.
And as a symbol of our unity.
And as a symbol of our unity.
I promise to support you.
I promise to support you.
Care for you.
Care for you.
And stand alongside you for all of our days.
And stand alongside you for all of our days.
Please place the ring on your finger. There we go. Now Terry. As you place this ring on his finger, please repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a pledge of my love.
As a pledge of my love.
And as a symbol of our unity.
And as a symbol of our unity.
I promise to support you.
I promise to support you.
Care for you.
Care for you.
And stand alongside you for all of our days. Please place the ring on his finger. Now, by the power of your love and the shockingly amount of power invested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Woo!
Can't wait for another night. I love myself around you. I can. Let one